Hey, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Stephen Inouye, and I will be your MC this afternoon. I've been a resident of Davis for almost 58 years, which, in the words of Davis legend Bob Dunning, qualifies me as being considered just past the stage of a newcomer in town. As a child, I had the opportunity of utilizing the Davis Joint Unified School District's music system with music educators like Mr. Luck, Mr. Gonzalez, Mr. Brunel, and Mrs. New. In regards to music, I currently serve on the DeSoma board, where my focus has been the last 2 years on our elementary music program. Our family has always been involved with the music programs, with our oldest son, Jason, who is now in college, our twin boys, Justin and John, who are current ninth graders at Harper. Much of my success, of course, has been made possible by my wife and best friend, Teresa, who continues supporting myself and our family in everything we do. I would bring her out, but she's volunteering all day in the backstage. First up, we have the All-City Orchestra, directed by Lydia, who also teaches strings at 5 different elementary schools in Davis. This group generally rehearses once a week and provides an essential first experience in ensemble play. I present our All-City Orchestra.
Thank you. what he's done. What he doesn't know is he's on his face.
Oh, in trouble, man.
Not in anything. But yes, you're right.
Well, I better watch that.
Well, I did tell him. And they said, oh, you're trying to talk to me. He said, no, you're going to deal with me tomorrow. I've been through this with him.
So the Davis School Orchestral Music Association, also known as DSOMA, is a volunteer-run nonprofit organization that celebrates, promotes, and supports a vision of comprehensive musical education that is accessible by all students in the Davis Joint Unified School District. We support Davis Joint Unified School District music programs behind the scenes with instrument and case repairs and replacements, sheet music, outreach, workshops, field trips, concert financial and logistical support, and the string scholarship tutoring program. Music in Davis is personally very important to me, and that is why I'm happy to volunteer my time. All these programs are only possible because of the generous support of music families, community members, private foundations, and local businesses. To all those that have donated in the past or plan to in the future, we thank you. Up next is the All City Band, directed by Nancy Sanchez. In addition, she also teaches at five different elementary schools in Davis and has the additional duties of elementary music coordinator. Like the orchestra, the All City Band also rehearses once a week and is generally the first experience these students have playing in an ensemble group. May I present, ladies and gentlemen, the All City Band.
Thank you.
special presentation for Mrs. Nancy Sanchez. And I can get away with this because I think she likes me a little, so we're okay. Hey, we wish to, walking onto the stage now is Dr. Darwin, who's our current president for the DeSoma Board. We wish to honor Mrs. Sanchez publicly with a gift, since she will unfortunately be retiring at the end of the year. She has given many years of dedicated service to our district, and we thank her for her services and wish her the very best in retirement. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for Nancy Sanchez. Segment, I would like to give a big thank you to Jim Rokop, who owns James Rokop Photography. He took his time to volunteer today and photograph each of the groups this morning during dress rehearsal. Jim is another longtime parent who has supported the music programs with his children through our school system. These group pictures will be made available for free. Each music teacher will directly contact their parents and explain how this will be done at each site. A big thank you to Jim Rokop. And while we're on the topic of media, the DeSoma Board would like to thank Tom Estes and Jeff Shaw from Davis Media Access, who are recording this afternoon's concert. The downloads will also be available later, and of course, each individual music teacher will be contacting any parents and explaining how this will be done. Please join me in also giving a big thank you to Tom Estes and Jeff Shaw. Woo! Next up, we have the combined junior conducted by both Greg Brucker and Luana Hernandez Howe. Mr. Brucker is a teacher at Harper Junior High School, and Ms. Hernandez Howe teaches at Emerson Da Vinci. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present the combined Junior High Intermediate Orchestra. Okay, hey, just wanted to thank our program sponsors for this afternoon's concert, who are also parents of students performing in a band, choir, and orchestras across all the junior high schools. Pacific Agroecology, April Milk Method Hand and Foot Challenge, Sacramento Master Singers, and Lucid Beads. In addition, we would like to also thank Mr. Jeff Simmons of Watermelon Music for his continuous support of local musicians. Up next, we have the combined junior high intermediate bands conducted by Greg Brucker, Luiz Coelho, and Luana Hernandez Howe. We've been introduced to Mr. Brucker and Mr. Hernandez Howe before, but let's talk about Mr. Coelho. He's a teacher at Holmes Junior High and also teaches the junior high jazz band in the mornings at Emerson. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the combined junior high intermediate bands. Thank you.
I
Okay, hey, I would like to take this time to thank all the educators, elected officials, and administrators that have always supported music and music education. There's actually a few of you that I've spoken to today in the hallways, and actually there's a few more that I see out in the audience, and as I've spoken here on stage today. In regards to educators, it's not just the music teachers, but all teachers from all subjects that come to concerts and take an interest in their students outside of their field of expertise. And of course, our private instructors that enhance musicianship. It's school board members and city council members, along with other elected officials, that have continued to support policies and legislation that benefits our children. And to our administrative staff that continue to support music and music education in good times and bad. I would like to give a shout out to our superintendent of schools, Matt Best, who has a long history of supporting our music programs. And finally, huge gratitude to the Davis Joint Unified School District's DAPA coordinator, Amy Martinez, who is even volunteering behind all day today in the scenes, back behind stage. All right, next we have the Junior High School Jazz Band under the direction of Luiz, Coelho.
Thank you.
pretty good. So folks, we'll take our short intermission now. We actually have to set up the stage for the choirs. It's really cool. They go up and down, and then they jump up and flies through the air, and all the bands over there somewhere. So maybe 15 minutes or so, that'll give enough people time to hopefully get to the restroom, meet friends and stuff. All right, we'll see you in about 15 to 20.
Thank you. Sibelius wrote it as a, for his country, weren't they in occupied at the time he wrote it as kind of a protest?
Thank you. no, they swap.
Sorry, what?
Oh, they said they swap. I guess.
Oh,
yeah.
Marta left. Did Marta leave?
They said that somebody came, so I assume they just swapped the thing, but
do you have space or you can figure something
out? Oh, I don't know what the question was.
My stepdaughter was the
speaker. Oh, okay, then no, we don't, actually. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want to. Because then it's not too bad.
Right, well, I don't know about you, but this has been a great concert so far. You ready for another half? And so first on the docket is our all-city choir, directed by Megan Kraft. Ms. Kraft also teaches general music and band at Birch Lane and North Davis Elementary Schools. The choir is joined today by pianist Maya Kyle. Folks, this is the first year of existence for the All City Choir, and this afternoon is their debut performance. Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, let's give them a warm welcome, our All City Choir.
Thank you.
was fantastic. All right, so we're going to bring back two of the other junior high teachers. The first one's going to do the next two songs. That's Miss Luana Hernandez Howe, and then Mr. Luis Coelho is going to come back and do the last one. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is now the junior high school choirs. Fine choirs. Okay, so besides intermission, this is probably going to be our longest set change as we bring the stage back up to the same levels. A couple students indicated to me that none of them went up and went to the back balcony areas, so I guess they didn't float after all. Well, let's do something educational here, and then we'll do a fun little game while they're bringing all these, and we can see the stage rise. That's always exciting, too. Some things about music that have been documented in studies that exist today about the effects of music education on academic achievement. You know, playing music requires using multiple skills at once. Reading music notation, watching and interpreting a conductor's movements, listening to pitches, counting beats in a time signature, coordinating with other players, and producing notes accurately. Doing these things activates part of the brain associated with learning and performing in other subjects. For instance, in the process of practicing and performing music, students cultivate abstract reasoning skills, a sharp memory, attentiveness, creative problem-solving abilities, and diligence, all of which are useful in a broad range of academic subjects. Though on this stage, in this venue, I know I'm just preaching to the choir, but it is important for us to continually send the message that music education is an essential for my kids, your kids, our kids. The best part is, though, that we are definitely beneficiaries of this wonderful concert, and I'm so happy to be at. Oh man, I took away your watching time with this.
No, I was watching it the whole time.
Alright, so I did this a little last year. We did like trivia of people and past and present, but I thought I'd keep it simpler today, make it a little more crowd interactive. We'll just go like true and false. So if you think it's true, go ahead and signal ear, cross hand, arm. Oh, no. You can just say true, or you can put up a T, or, you know, you can yell it really loud. But just be careful, because if that person whispers false right next to you, and you yell true and it's really false, that might be embarrassing, but that's okay. All right, let's go. How about this? True or false? String instruments are found only in orchestras.
False!
Wait, I love how people said true. Oh, no, it is false. It is false. Oh, here's one. Made of wood. A piano is part of the percussion family.
True.
You know, the drums and stuff. True or false?
True.
Did you see that? They have the right answer right over there. I see it back there. That's correct. It is true. It is part of the percussion family. For those that play, you'll laugh at this. A legislator is used to hold the reed to the mouthpiece. True or false? It is false. I used the wrong word that sounded the same. How about this? Some brass instruments use reeds. Yes, I see you right there. Yes, I see you in that nice outfit. Is that pinkish? Yeah, she got it right. It's false.
Do it.
All right, here's a trick question, so be careful. And what I'm going to read to you is a true statement, but saxophones that are made out of brass, and you know, saxophones are made out of brass, those ones and those ones only belong to the brass family.
False!
False!
Careful. These are made out of brass. Yeah, it's false. There's reeds. There's no. They have reeds, they're woodwind. Unlike the flute, right, which has no reed. Oh, let's do that. A flute is considered a brass instrument. Yeah, that's false. It's a woodwind. Using wooden sticks, playing the drums, makes drums when you use the sticks a woodwind.
True!
I didn't believe it either. It's totally false. It's not good at all. A conductor, you know, like those things that are used with circuits and, you know, all that. Directs an orchestra.
True!
It's true, a conductor directs an orchestra. Here's one that's really simple, because everyone knows. A baritone saxophone is generally considered a very small instrument.
Oh!
Yeah. Even a tenor saxophone, your parents are trombones or cellos, you know. Good gosh, why couldn't my kid do like a pickle? Let's see. Here's one. A violin. You know, you see it, right? Has six strings.
Oh!
No, a violin. Okay. Six strings. Well, guitarists might have six strings, but no, a violin only has four. It is false. Brilliant people out there. Ooh! A piano. Hopefully they put it away, because I don't want someone to cheat.
I know.
Yeah, she was gonna cheat. Yeah, I know. A piano has 88 keys.
Oh, true! That actually is true. I built that
myself. Careful, you know, I could pick any number.
True!
That only one will be true. A piano has 88 keys.
Do it!
Yeah, that's mostly true. I guess it depends on your piano. Mostly true.
Does it count for
play? Oh, here's something, because it's nice, right? A group of two musicians or singers, right? You have two of them. It's called a couple.
Oh, it's called a duet.
Yeah. Does anyone know what it is?
Duet!
Did you say duet?
Yeah.
Here's something that we know is not true because they have different tightnesses. Strings on a guitar are different thicknesses. It's true. Estimating roughly, approximately to four decimal places, the square root of 2 is 1.4142.
True.
That's not a lot. All right, well, I guess my math really helps. Yeah, that's true. I actually teach math, and I tell my students, like, you see that book there, my CRC handbook for physics, chemistry, and math? Yeah, that's what we use because there were no computers back then. So, for those that, you know. All right. So, I'll save these other things for the next time if we need to solve them. Because look how fast they move.
Right.
So I'll come back when they're ready and we bring the kids out. Hey, thanks for playing the game. By the way, if you got them right, all of them, and you have the special coupon that's under your seat, you just won $1,000. Okay, stay tuned next time. I did have an A, B, C, D trivia question. This, you know, I had a third year of those, but we'll do those next time. Hey, so, but I do want to thank a special group that's out in our audience here today, and that's the parents, right? So, you're the ones that endure, you know, those hot cross Mondays, and the screeching of the screams, and the squeaking, and the brass sounds that you wonder what's going to happen, and try to watch Music Man and say that it'll be okay. You drive your kids to rehearsals, you lug, like we had talked about, those little teeny baritone saxophones, or those cellos, or those basses, all over the place. And, you know, without you and what you do for your kids, it wouldn't sound this good. I mean, and it sounded fantastic today. So let's give a big round of applause for yourselves. Orchestra. And boy, folks, you are in for a treat today. I'll just announce both the directors because we've seen them before. First one up will be Luana Hernandez Howe, and the second one will be Mr. Greg Brucker. Let's give them a warm welcome and to our Junior High Advanced Orchestra. Send out to you as parents that you got, coordinating with the Mondavi staff and everything at UC Davis that you see here, dealing with 6 music directors, 9 different groups, 125 parent volunteers today, all backstage, that you did not see, and around 435 musicians. Ladies and gentlemen, this young lady coordinated it all. It is her. Luiz, Coelho, and Greg Brucker, all coming back to direct the final group. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for spending the evening with me. Enjoy the last group.
Thank you. good. All right. Hi, everybody. I want to thank you all for sticking it out on a long concert. We had a couple extra groups this year, and I just am so impressed with every single musician for all across this day for how they did through the rehearsal process and the concert. I really couldn't be personally more proud of everybody. I want to give a big, big thank you to our directors all around, Mr. Hernandez, Mr. Coelho. Congratulations. We're really, really glad we're able to do this together. I also want to give a big thank you to the DSOMA team who helped organize and run the concert. It's absolutely phenomenal their work. And you can always use some help on the board if you're interested. And as well, the Mondavi crew did a brilliant job doing one of the more complex concerts and doing all this transition. Let's give the crew a big, big hand. Are on the right track for funding that we hope to keep going for a long time, and I can't thank you enough for that. So it's been a long day. I'm sure everybody's tired. I really appreciate y'all sticking it out. Congratulations, directors, musicians, congratulations. Thank you all very much.